Good morning. Today, I want to take a class on a poetry, namely Don and Puri by Jayanta Mohapatra. Before starting the poetry, I steer a glance on poet and his works. Jayanta Mohapatra is one of the major poets of Indian English literature. He is the first English poet to win the Sahitya Academy Award for his poetry. He also was awarded the Padma Shri in the year 2009. He has authored 27 books of poetry, of 7 which are in Oriya and the rest in English. Firstly, I want to analyze the title of the poetry. What is the title of the poetry? The title of the poetry is Don and Puri. In this title, we get 2 names or 2 words. First word is Don. What is the meaning of the dawn? Yes? The meaning of the dawn is early morning. Early morning suggests the word dawn. And the next word is Puri. All of you know that Puri is an eminent place for some reasons. Puri is an eminent place in the state of Orissa. It is a famous place for various reasons. The great temple of Jagannatha, the Shishur, and the annual program held on the occasion of Lord Jagannatha are the main reasons of attractions for the visitors and common people of India. Now, I go through the poetry and I analyze the whole poetry according to stanza wise. Okay, what is the first stanza? The first stanza is endless crow noises, a skull in the holy sands, tills its empty country towards hunger. The poet ruminates at the beach premises of Orissa. The endless calling of crows strikes the poet's attention at the outset. He then notices a skull on the beach where human bodies are normally cremated. The word skull refers to poverty and the moral stagnations of the people of Orissa. These crows are in huge number. According to the poet, not only the crows but also the people of Orissa are suffering from poverty and starvation. The phrase empty country towards hunger emphasizes the same. The nihilism in a non-productive life. The word skull represents the hollowness of life, the moral stagnity and pseudo-existence of Orissa. Actually, through this stanza, the poet tries to present a harsh, realistic life and society of Orissa and Orissa's culture. Then we go through the second stanza. The second stanza is white-clad widowed women, past the centers of their lives, are waiting to enter the great temple. After a while, the poet notices a number of women adorned white saris, and they are stand in a row to enter the great temple of Jagannatha for performing their customary rites and rituals. These widowed women have nothing more to lose, and they have sacrificed all their belongings for the sake of the Lord Jagannatha. This woman adorned white sarees, and it represents the peace and tranquility of their mind. Next, we come to the third stanza. The third stanza is, their austere eyes stare like those caught in a net, hanging by the dawn's shining strands of fate. According to the poet, these women's looks are so serene and calm. A sense of serenity are found in their eyes. It bears the sense of loss of everything in their life. Their conditions are just like the birds caught in a net, having nothing more to lose as they remain captured. Their conditions are just like the birds who are caught in a net. In this stanza, the poet Jayanta Mahapatra beautifully described the deplorable condition of the widowed woman who belongs to the Hindu culture and Hindu religion. Then we come to the next stanza, the fourth stanza. The faint early light ruined leprous shells leaning against one another, a mass of crouched faces without limbs. It is a time of dawn, so it is very clear to all of us that in the time of dawn, all the lights are dim and flimsy. The dim and flimsy lights falls upon the leprous shells, which are leaning against one another, at a seashore of pain. Then we come to the next stanza. And suddenly breaks out of my height into the smoky blaze of silent solitary fire that fills my aging mother. The poet then notices a single fire is burning at the seashore of Orissa. Then a sudden thought becomes arise in his mind, which is related to his mother's thought, to his mother's last wish. His mother's last wish is that she will be cremated at that same place after her death. It's come across strongly to the poet's mind. Yes, it is very natural. Religious, rituals, cultures, all these are very mandatory. However, perhaps performing one's mother's duty is far more important than any type of religious rituals and customs. Her last wish to be cremated here, twisting uncertainly like tide on the shifting sands. The poet come to this place to performing his mother's funeral rites. According to poet, all these religious rituals and customs are baseless. It has no importance in our daily life. After analyzing the whole poetry, it is clear to all of us that the poet Jayanta Mahapatra brings a scathing attack on tradition and traditional practices, which are so biased and baseless. The poet Jayanta Mahapatra tries to criticize the fossilized Hindu culture and the patriarchal society of Indian culture, where women are totally deprived from getting any type of facility in their everyday life. Thank you.